So I'd like to tell you a bit about the progress in creating AI scientists so that perhaps one day in the future a Nobel Prize in Science might be awarded to a computer. In order to convey how this process works, I'll need to take you a little bit deeper into technical details of my field, nanophotonics. I like to joke with my graduate students that the goal of this is to replace graduate students with AI. Somehow they never laugh when I tell this joke. So, ideally you would like to train AI scientists in a lab, but such a real-world environment is very difficult and messy for today's AI systems to navigate in. One of the reasons why computers are so successful in finance is because you can close the entire finance loop on a computer. Fortunately, there are a few fields of science in which you can simulate experiments basically exactly on a computer, and such fields are particularly suitable for training AI scientists. My field, nanophotonics, is one such field. In nanophotonics, we create these artificially created materials which are structured at length scales substantially smaller than the wavelength of light, and their nanostructure determines their optical properties. By tailoring the nanostructure, we can tailor the laws of physics, at least as far as light is concerned, almost at will. You can think of nanophotonics as being a subfield of nanotechnology that deals with light. And in terms of applications, these are lasers, LEDs, solar cells, optical fibers, things like that. Let me illustrate this on an example of a project that we recently worked on. And that project dealt with this amazing light bulb, which not only lit up the world, but was the best lighting device that we had for nearly 100 years. Now, unfortunately, now we have to abandon it because it's very inefficient. It sends most light into infrared, and only a small portion goes into visible. So we were wondering whether we can use nanophotonics techniques to enhance the efficiency of this ultimately challenging system. To do that, we need to recycle infrared light back onto the filament. So we did detailed numerical optimization of the system, and then we fabricated it. And as you can see, real experiments really reproduce numerical experiments point by point, and that way we were able to enable a 3 times more efficient incandescent light bulb. Now, our nanophotonics process often starts by first calculating something called bands of our nanophotonic system. And bands are very important to us because they tell us how this system will respond when illuminated with a light of given frequency. For example, they tell us whether it will transmit or reflect light depending on the incoming wavelength and angle, as you have seen on the previous slide. Now, we can easily calculate bands of many very different nanophotonic systems, and then we can use this plenty of data in order to train our AI scientists. This ease of generating data is one of the things which makes nanophotonics so suitable for training AI scientists, because then we can use this data so that our AI systems would develop a feeling for behavior of these systems, like you can see on this slide. We can show it a new nanophotonic system it has never seen, and it can come up with an excellent prediction of what the bands of this system are. You can say that it developed a physical intuition for behavior of these systems. Like, for example, as you can see here, red dots denote neural network prediction, and the rest are the true results. You can see there is an excellent match. Perhaps even more interesting would be if we had some desired bands, and neural network could tell us how does the physical system have to look like to give us this physical behavior. Such task requires some creativity, and creativity is supposedly something that computers are not good at. But recently, AI systems did start appearing which are creative. So the way this works is you can train two neural networks together, and this bottom one learns a function which transforms any arbitrary noise into images of a given desired class, in this case, human faces. The dogs that you see on the screen do not exist in the real life. They've all been imagined by a neural network of the type I've shown you before, simply starting from noise. And people have used this same AI systems to invent new music, to create new art paintings, and then actually sell these art paintings for a lot of money. We use the same AI system in order to get it to create for us completely new nanophotonic systems simply starting from noise. And now we have AI system that can imagine as many new nanophotonic systems of given desired properties as we want. Now, job of a scientist is also sometimes to discover the underlying laws that govern the behavior of a given physical system. So here is an example of wave behavior. Neural networks can excellently predict behavior of such waves, but they can also discover the underlying physical law governing the behavior of these systems. And I would like to end on a provocative note, and that is that science might very well be the most important field that AI has a chance of cracking in the next 20 to 40 years. Because if we manage to crack science, that could help us solve many of the world's most important problems, including climate change, cancer, and many others. Thank you very much for your attention.